Hi guys, this is Mukesh Singh from Woodman Model School Darbhanga, and in this video I'm going to deal with the poetic devices used in the poem A Thing of Beauty. In this poem the poet has used many poetic devices, so let's consider each and every stanza one by one. A thing of beauty is a joy forever. Its loveliness increases. It will never pass into nothingness, but will keep a bower quiet for us, and a sleep full of sweet dreams, and health and quiet breathing. If we consider the rhyme scheme of this poem, of this stanza, then we will find that its rhyme scheme is AABBC, because the first line ends with the word forever, and it gives the sounds forever, ever, and the second line ends with the word never. The same sound is there, never, were. Then the third line, keep, with the fourth, sleep. So keep and sleep rhyme with each other. And then breathing, ing sound is there. The other figure of speech used here is alliteration. What is alliteration? Alliteration is the use of consonant sound at the start of two words which are close in series. For example, the same sound, consonant sound, S sound or S sounds is repeated in the words sleep and sweet. Then the other figure of a speech or poetic device used here is metaphor. Bower quiet. Calmness of the bower is compared to the calming effect, to the soothing effect of a beautiful thing. Therefore, on every morrow are we reading a flowery band to bind us to the earth. Spite of despondence, of the inhuman dearth, of novel natures, of the gloomy days, of all the unhealthy and over darkened ways made for our searching, yes, in spite of all, some shape of beauty moves away the pall from our dark spirits. The poetic devices used here are anaphora, alliteration, metaphor, imagery, inversion, and rhyme scheme is there. What is anaphora? Anaphora is the use of same word in two consecutive lines. So here in this stanza, of novel natures and of all the unhealthy ways. So anaphora is used because these two lines start with the same word of. Then the other poetic device used here is alliteration. We have earlier seen what is alliteration. Alliteration is the use of consonant sound at the start of two words which are close in series. Bur in band, bur sound in band and bind is repeated in close series or is used. Then no sound is there, no consonant sound in noble as well as in nature, and then again S sound in some, or so sound in some, and the word shape. The next metaphor has been used here. Reading a flowery band. In reading a flowery band, metaphor is used. The poetic device used here is metaphor. The beautiful thing of our life bind us to the earth. And here, a flowery band has a metaphorical meaning. It denotes a beautiful thing that binds to the earth. As flowers are woven into a flowery band, in the similar manner, a flowery band which denotes a beautiful thing, or the flowers which denote beautiful things bind us to this earth, to our life. Then the poet has used imagery here. The poet has created images. He has created a sensory effect of beautiful things lined up in a string, a flowery band to bind us. Poet has also used inversion here. Inversion is a normal order of words when the normal order of words is reversed. So are we reading? Instead of writing we are reading a flowery band, the poet has written are we reading. So he has reversed the order of words. So inversion is search the sun, the moon, trees old and young, sprouting a shady boon for simple sheep and such a daffodils, with a green world they live in and clear rills that for themselves a cooling cover to make against the hot season. The mid forest break, rich with sprinkling of fair musk rose blooms. In this stanza, the poet has used alliteration, imagery, and antithesis. Alliteration, we have seen alliteration, that is use of consonant sound at the start of two words which are close in series. And here, in the word sprouting shady, the same S or S consonant sound is repeated in sprouting and shady. Then in simple sheep, the same S sound is repeated, and the K sound in cooling and covert words. Then the poet has used imagery here, trees giving shade, sprouting shady boon, growing process of daffodils with the green world they live in, clean river streams. These are the imagery or the images that the poet creates in our mind through the lines of the poem. The poet has also used antithesis here. Antithesis means the use of the opposite words when the opposite words are placed together or juxtaposed together. The poet has used here the two words having opposite meanings, and these words are old and young, and such too is the grandeur of the dunes we have imagined for the mighty dead. All lovely tales that we have heard or read, an endless fountain of immortal drink. The poet has used many literary devices in this stanza. Alliteration has been used here, metaphor is used here, and rhyme scheme is there, and imagery. So the poet has used alliteration, the same sound, her sound, et sound is repeated in have, in the words have and heard. Then the poet has used metaphor in immortal dreams. Beautiful objects of nature are forever like a never-ending portion of a drink. The rhyme scheme is same, AABBC. The poet has used imagery here, bushes full of musk rose, sprinkling of fair musk rose blooms, books describing valor of fighters, that is stories describing valor, bravery of fighters. Grandeur is associated with mighty dead. Grandeur, mighty dead, God providing us with best things pouring from the heaven's brink. So we have seen that how the poet John Keats has used many poetic devices, and by using these poetic devices he has made this poem very beautiful and effective. So my dear students, thank you for watching this video.